domain blocking that's very important. Instead of blocking blocking. So principle of isolation board. We cover the proportions, the best proportion. What is AGB? Stand for additional training procedures. Action placement topic and what which domain. Click on that. Setup production, very easy. Everybody in the healthcare, say the hospital, will do this for flow. Regardless of what you want. You include FIG, disinfection, sterilizing environment, for the pandemic or anything. PPE, where there is needed vaccines, such as CRE and also this product, the wear, the gloves, and gloves, and health. Environmental hygiene, they include management of the unit of waste product, also for the yellow bean, and if you sneeze, not very much, please cover your mouth, of course, to prevent it from breaking down. So, transmission best precaution is contact with your blood airborne, but flu also is a common and known contribution in COVID. Contact precautions in contact. So, what are the precautions of the flu? These precautions are mentioned in the following. And contribution identified to reduce the risk of transmission of concern by direct contact. So you need to hand wash, wear the glove, and gloves. So contact precautions, usually isolate patients in the rooms. If isolate is not available, then you contact those patients with separate in the same area. This is concerned immediate concern to us. And the nurse know identify which are patients, so they will take the measure. Droplet situations. Actually, COVID is measured through droplet precautions. Why is it droplet? It's big enough, more than 5 microns, it's heavy. So, when you cough, it means you put droplets, whatever go up or go up, will come down with gravity. So, you'll drop in 3 feet, or the most to 6 feet. That's why the magic number is maintained 1 meter or 2 meter away from the those who are suspected, or anybody. No, because up to 50% of mild infections, asymptomatic, do not show anybody of you who carry the germs, the COVID, but still able to go. Especially when you're vaccinated, you are less likely to be the severe. So, common statement that one of the early consultants being used is be paranoid. All the people surrounding you or environment are considered contaminated or infected and you've proven otherwise, right? Droplet precautions, surgical mask is enough, but in the situation whereby you are taking the airborne, then you need to wear an N95. Actually, this airborne is because it's very fine and small and light. You can suspect the air from as short as 30 minutes and most of the cases will be hours. And this airborne pressure is not confined to COVID, also can happen in chicken pox, but it's in 30 plus meters. So you require an N95 to prevent this or to filter up this small quantity. Usually the patient will be put in the negative pressure room, correct? And you apply the N95 in, lock off in the empty room. So, that is the data I mentioned before. Majority are pro transmissions, correct? Airborne transmission is possible, but not yet proven, but cases were reported whereby a lot of people find it when the interview is up. It's a very confined space, right? And also in the FM, where the test was, but FM is put within the regulations. So it's not been proven, but it's still tech. And when you join the COVID team in what is HSP, most of the patients are they have to have mask, face mask, and suddenly are non-respirator. So they are considered HP, also therapy procedures. So when you go into the region, you need to wear them. So why the HP? Intubation and expiration, of course, will cause HP more. Because you're very close to the patient, you need to see the antibodies, see the equation. manual ventilation is great for tagging. Like, it's still working for the one for soap and cost of the aerosol. The other one that more pertaining to the patients in the world is COPD asthma patients. We don't use that already now because that can generate aerosol. We replace by using either those inhaler, NPI or inhaler. Okay, to replace the inhalation. Even to do so, we use return a certain type of patient is to be in the isolation room, particularly in the pressure room. We do an pressure room after the mat, open the door and reserve ready. The airflow by 1 hour, then you will clear off the virus from the air. Okay. Aerosol jet procedures. So, I think this is for the latest angle of the slices now. Okay. When you want to perform it, don't think of that it's very necessary or not. Because in the COVID patients, you want to do the suctioning or anything else, please, we have got the necessary precautions. We also ask you, even though they are wearing the full PPE, when you can identify, you have to reduce. Alright? So they will still hold suctions. There's more of a question in the world for control COVID-19, how much are the toxic patients? Patients under surveillance is soft. In the case whereby some of the patients may be getting suddenly go through, having two positive, so you cannot look at all together, provided you have enough consideration. You do have a much better and advise the patient to mingle among yourself because you might be getting other than positive if you can't be. It's rather you have positive exposure. So when they're in there, do ask them to wear the clean eye mask. Joining in isolations, very colorful, green, yellow, red. Green is very sad, pertaining to the approach where the hepatitis slip in, changing rooms, prayer rooms, bath, toilet, and treat administrated area. Yellow joins to the nurse counter. Nurse counter is the sun ward. The location or position of the counter is right in front of the patient's bed. So that area is 1 meter of the patient's. But most of the ward in the COVID, they are further away from the patients. Red zones, of course, is near the patients, which is 1 meter. Then number two, just remember, you are in the yellow zones, should be certain by now. I think most of the adjoining area now, 5 days red, in some Japan, you don't find us. So, you know the yellow or red, please wear the blue. In the green zone, wear your surgical mask, or in the area where you find a lot of AGP, red and white. And do wear your focus or face shield. Right? So, PPE. Comprises of the following instruments that you need to apply on. Very important before you eat food and washing that go through them. So PPE for when you're going to apply on when you go into the patient, the zone with suspected global or some case, this is the thing that you need to wear. When you provide the care performing oral facial restriction, please wear any. Do you guys notice something is lacking? What is lacking?
Shoe cover.
Shoe cover. Is it very necessary?
Yes.
CDC and
WHO. Oh, tak payah.
Shoe cover or cover is not necessary.
Oh.
But whereby when you make this, when you make body fits, build on, you can produce positive pressure inside that, so that the air will go inside and you can start to go through the line. Alright, this is really used in the ICU, very limited item, so not all can use it. But two of the air and go in the ward, because you want to do that. Very important, if you want to wear 10 to 5 body size for better stuff, you must make sure that that end is suitable for you. Not one size fit all. Everybody has a small size face, with a face, and with angles. You create edges with gaps so that the air can leak. What I mean leak is not only up, but in. You bring in, to go through the side, then you feel. So you can do it by yourself by doing a self-check. How to do it? Very simple. When you tie and identify this method area, make an extension in the middle right, get your tie on the top of the muscle grip, press it, then you hold it like this. Look, exhale gently to see whether the energy does grow or it sets. It's very okay that some escape and minimal escape. After that stuff, breathing to see whether there is a negative pressure to the side so you can see your muscle. If you sense that there is a lot of leakage or this better position back to the back, do find out the performance. We have performed a proper regenerative test. If I don't play, think of you. Then we can do the X-ray things for that. Tell you what are the steps that you can demonstrate the cost of the result. Okay. And CDC recommend that you need to perform this test annually. And if let's say you see new brand failures, don't think that you're comfortable with the self-check test with others, then you do the necessary one. Joining doping. Notice a lot of people do not use the respiratory hand rub before your PPE. It's very important. You are not hurting yourself, you're supposed to protect your patients. So if your hands is soiled with a lot of the so, first step, do head wrap. Second, follow the steps here. But head wrap in between. For instance, before you wear your N95, very important. You take out your sleeping mask, head wrap, and wear your N95. Because if you do wear your wash your hands, you might touch your face. And you might touch the surface of the N95. Just imagine. Then the surface will probably put the mask, the nose is putting every time. Top to go to the mask. So do hand up before this one. Another hand up is before you apply the gloves. Right? Because the gloves is the one that instantly exposes the patients. You want to protect the patients from the other components. Topic. I look forward to this, but just a few things I'd like to ask. Just to remind you, when you don't follow the sequence, the most dirtiest, most contaminated, so where you go up first. Which one is the most contaminated? Gloves. That's why you ask two gloves, two layer gloves. When you take it out, it's still a month for you. Just look at it, pinch, take out the first layer, go up. Same for this one. Second thing is most contaminated is
Inside here, and then, Thank you.